Assalamu alaikum. We are from Group 1. So we want to introduce ourselves first. So my name is Afnan Shahi bin Awakar and my IP number is 177732.
My name is
Nur
Amira
binti Muhammad
Najri. My
matric
number is
18707. My name is Muhammad Shamil Abdul Majid. My matric number is
185162. Okay, next. Okay, for introduction, sewage treatment is the process of removing contaminant from wastewater, primarily from household sewage. Okay, it includes physical, chemical, and biological process to remove this contaminant and produce environmentally safer treated wastewater. A byproduct of sewage treatment is usually a semi-solid waste or slurry called sewage sludge that has to undergo further treatment before being suitable for disposal or land application. Okay, for operation, sewage water treatment can be divided into two parts, which is primary treatment and secondary treatment. Okay, for primary treatment, firstly, the raw sewage will enter the bath screen. Okay, in the bath screen, it's to remove large floating objects such as wood, rag, plastic, garbage, and the element. And after that, the sewage, the sludge, will be transferred to bleach chamber. In bleach chamber, it removes the inorganic particle. In order to prevent damage to the pump and to prevent the accumulation in sludge digester. Okay, after that, the sludge will go through primary settling. In primary settling, it's designed to reduce the velocity of wastewater flow for organic solid to settle. Okay, for secondary treatment, the sludge will undergo aeration tank. Okay, in aeration tank, the effluent will undergo further treatment, which is aerobic oxidation. And after that, it will be transferred to secondary settling. In secondary settling, allow the microorganism and other settle and other solid to settle after secondary or biological treatment. This sludge is pumped back into the inlet end of the primary sedimentation tank and settled with the raw sludge. Okay. Next, sludge from primary and secondary will enter thickener. In thickener, the sludge from primary and secondary will be still often added with clarifying agent to form larger, more rapidly settling aggregate. And lastly, the sludge drying bed is the most widely used method for sludge dewatering. Sludge drying involves natural way of drying to mechanical way of removing water content. Okay, next, I will pass to Shamil.
Okay, for the next part is about the motor we use in our drainage system. So for the first motor we use is a squirrel cage induction motor. So why we use this motor? Because the first one is high efficiency. Most of the motor is around 99.7 efficiency of the squirrel cage induction motor. So this motor is a 3-phase induction motor, which is use a 3-phase AC source to make a rotating magnetic field. So why we use this motor also? Because the speed is cannot be controlled. Because this motor is just used for the water pump, which is we need to pump the water into the settling tank. So this squirrel cage induction motor is used to pump the water into the setting tank. Next. So this is our trilogy part that use a squirrel cage induction motor. So the motor pump is normally squirrel cage and this motor is controlled by the manual switch and level sensor. So the level sensor is inside the setting tank, which is when the water in the setting tank reach the level that we want, so it will open circuit, so the water pump will close. So the manual switch is normally controlled by the user, which is you want to pump water, we just push a manual switch so that the motor will pump the water into the setting tank. So this is a motor component of the squirrel cage. For the first part is a stator and the rotor. The rotor is a rotating part, and the stator is a part that needs a three-phase AC source. So the stator will provide a rotating magnetic field. So at the rotor, it composed of red copper bar slightly longer than the rotor, which are pushed into slot. So the opposing end of the bar is connected by the end ring. So the closed circuit will make the current flow in the end ring. So how it works? The first one is the operation of three-phase induction motor is based on the Faraday's law and Lorentz force on the conductor. So next is about synchronous speed. Synchronous speed is speed of the rotating magnetic field, and the rotor speed will less than the synchronous speed. We call that slip. So slip will make the motor rotate. So after when the motor is rotated, water will flow in the center tank. So this is our full program in the trilogy. So for the first one is when the operator or user push the manual switch, it will make a water pump into the center tank. So this is water pump, and then when the level sensor in the center tank reach the value that we want, it will open circuit, which is the water pump will off. So as the level sensor is off, the time in tank is set in 6 seconds. But in reality, the time is set around 6 days, because to make sure that all the organic solid or sludge is go down into the second tank. So this time in tank, when it reach 6 seconds, the door of the setting tank will open, and sludge vent also will open. So the organic solid will move into the sludge valve, and the door setting will make the water move into the sludge digester and sludge dryer. Next is the door setting, which we have two setting tanks. First is setting 1 and setting tank 2. So this is the door setting tank 2, which is motor pump 2 will start to rotate. Motor pump 2 also we use a squirrel cage induction motor. So if the motor pump into the setting tank 2, the oxygen will provide to make sure the aeration is in the aeration tank. So this is the level sensor in the setting tank 2. Same as the previous one, when the it reach the level we want, the time in tank 2 will in tank 2, we make sure that in 6 seconds, which is 6 days, like tank 1. So after 6 days, the door at setting tank 2 will open. After that, it will go into the chlorine tank. So at the chlorine tank, it will provide a chlorine to kill a bacteria. And lastly, chlorine valve will open and go to the river. So the pump river is a clean water. Next. Next.
Okay, I will explain about manipulated and control variable for this drainage system. For manipulated variable, first is water pump. Pump are used to push the contaminated water or sewage in the plant to pass through different treatment process. Okay, commonly used pump in various wastewater treatment are sewage pump, centrifugal pump, submersible water pump, and water pressure booster pump. Okay, second manipulated variable are pump at the setting tank. Pump can be used at the discharge point to prevent the water from entering the pipeline. Okay, for control variable is water level. Wastewater level monitoring in sewage treatment plant is an essential control parameter for numerous sedimentation basin, setting tank, aeration basin, and clarifier. They are involved. involved in the sewage treatment process.
So these are motor control circuit. We have three motor control circuit, which is magnetic contactor, overload relay, and circuit breaker. The first is magnetic contactor. It's normally used electromagnetic induction. When the excess current is moved into the circuit, the magnetic contactor will make the circuit is open circuit, so that the current will not flow in the circuit. The difference between the magnetic contactor and overload relay is overload relay is non-movement part. This normally used a PIC, but the operation is same like a magnetic contactor, which is when the load is overload or excess current in the circuit, the relay will open the circuit so that the current will not flow into the circuit. Next. So this is a this is about VFD. VFD is normally used in a wound rotor. So how we want to control the speed of the wound rotor? So VFD is stand for a variable speed control of AC driver. So normally it's just change the frequency to change the speed. If the frequency increase, the speed is also increased. That's all. So for this, to change the frequency, you have three stage, which is activator stage, inverter stage, and control system. So this is about one wound rotor that we explained the previous one. The wound rotor is the advantage is we can control the speed. It's based on the frequency. Okay. Next. Okay.
So this might be my part. So this is an off controller for the wound rotor. So first. This control is the element that has only two state, which is fully closed or fully open. In this control system, when the process variable changes and crosses a certain preset level, the output valve of the system is suddenly fully open and gives 100% output. So, hence, due to the effect of the output, the process variable gain starts changing but in reverse direction. In this stage, when the process variable closes a certain preset level, the output valve of the system is immediately closed and output is suddenly zero. So we can refer to the graph. Okay. Yes. A very common example of on-off control theory is a water level sensor operating water pump. So when the water level, for example, when the water level in the water reservoir reaches a certain level, the controller will fully open the water pump and on until the level drop to the minimum level for the reservoir, then the water pump will turn off. When the pump is start and run across the line, it will provide the for VHD for the pump. So for example, when the pump is start and run across the line, it will provide maximum flow at optimal efficiency. So a pump water operate continuously at a full rate. Speed is inefficient during the period where the maximum flow is not required. So one method is we use a better pumping system is use the inlet control. Thanks. So why we use the VFD? So the first one is the use the minimum amount of energy. So reduce the second one is the reduce motor starting battery. Next is provide a degree of motor protection. The next one is cut the wear. is that it reduces the deployment quiet method attempts. So, because the VFD is the system that can control the current efficient, control the motor efficiently. So, we can have all this advantage of using the VFD. So, I think this system is better in water system.
I think the can you go to the previous slide about the on-off controller? Okay, I want to add something about the on-off controller. So normally it is used in the wound rotor. So the wound rotor is at the valve of the setting tank, which is the door. So when the water reach the value that we want, which is like for example like 70 centimeter, it will become on. So it become on, the door will open like that. When the water is not reach the 70 centimeter, the door is closed. So we just use two controller, which is one off controller. We don't use like a PID, proportional, integral. We just use on off controller because we just need to control the door, which is open or closed. That's all. That's all from our group. Thank you.